Creating and studying your first deck. The initial screen shows the decks you have installed. The pre-installed introduction deck gives a quick overview of how to use the app. In the samples folder are two decks that highlight some of the various features of the app. To add a new deck, tap plus at top right. In today's video, we'll look at two of the options you see here. First is Shared Library, where you can download flashcards that other users have shared. Tap Shared Library. Search. Enter a subject. Here are some Spanish sets that users have created. I will download the first set. You can see the new Adjectives deck added. I'll show you how to delete this deck. On iOS, you can swipe left on a deck row to delete. On Android, tap Edit at top right, then look for the Delete button at the bottom. Next, we'll create an empty deck and add cards from within the app. Tap plus, then choose Empty Deck. Name the deck and create. Now we are looking at the list of cards in the deck. Currently there are none. Tap plus to add a new card. At the top are three blank rows, which represent side 1, side 2, and side 3. Tap the top blank row, and you can now type in your question. Tap next to move to side 2. Type your answer. Tap done to return to card details screen. You can tap plus here to add another card, or if you are done adding cards, tap top left corner to return to the card listing screen, as I'll do now. I will add two more cards and be right back. We now have three cards in our deck, and it's time to start studying. Go back, and you will return to the deck list. To study, tap the new deck. To flip the card and view the answer, tap the screen. Next, we tell the app if we got the card correct or wrong. Swipe left to answer correct, and notice the green check mark flash at the top. Tap to flip. I didn't know this card, so I'll answer wrong. Swipe down to answer wrong, and notice the red X flash at the top. Flip. Answer correct. At the end, you'll see a summary report. Tap to continue studying. I will go over three common setting changes. Notice the gear icon at the top right. This will bring you to deck options, where you can change various settings for the current deck. The first one is card order, where we can have the cards shuffled. Tap and change to random. Tap X to close deck options. The cards have been shuffled. The next setting is repeat missed. This will repeat any cards you missed, giving you more practice where you need it. The third setting is show side first, which allows you to show the back side of the card first so you can study the other direction. For example, when studying a language. The icon at the bottom right, that looks like two cards, will take you to the card list screen. We've seen this screen before. This allows you to easily view all the cards in your deck, search for cards, and add new cards. Let me return to the deck listing, and I'll show you the deck edit screen, where you can do things like change the deck name and export your flashcards. Tap Edit at the top right, then tap the deck. The second row, Deck Code, defines the location of this deck in the cloud, but this is not applicable for this deck yet. If you are creating cards directly in the app, it is important that you export occasionally so you have a backup. Tap Export Share. If your deck does not have pictures or sounds, exporting by email is an easy option. I'll go over the other export options in the next video. Return to the deck listing and exit edit mode by tapping Done. Notice another gear icon here at top left. This takes you to Global Options, which are settings generally not deck specific. Card Theme allows you to change the color and look of your flashcards. For example, give them a white background instead of black. Control allows you to do things like answer with taps, instead of swipes, or showing correct and wrong buttons at the bottom of the study screen. In the View menu, you can turn off the card flip animation while studying. for a faster experience. You should now be able to create your own flashcards and study them. Many people will instead want to create their flashcards outside of the app, in a spreadsheet or text editor. I'll go over this procedure in the next video. In videos after that, I'll go over many of the app's more advanced options. Thanks for watching.